Welcome to handsome Hanbury Manor in Hertfordshire for the inaugural TK Maxx Comic Relief Golf Day in association with the William Hunt Trilby Tour. In the sumptuous surroundings of this Jacobean estate, the best golfers the rag trade can muster faced off, fessed up, and hammered it out to determine who is the least worst player among some, let's be honest, pretty poor excuses for sportsmen. The Sky Sports cameras were there to capture every stroke, every poke, and every choke. We've edited out the worst stuff, then had to put it back in again, otherwise this programme would have ended up being just 25 seconds long. So, here it is, the best of the worst of the stuff that was left after we took out the real rubbish. Coming up, we have some pretty poor golf and the odd bit that isn't too distressing. We have first tee interviews with Trilby Tour Supremo William Hunt and his newly appointed mini-me, Dan Hanbury. And we can enjoy several trips to see the bunkers, clunkers and plonkers who make a show of themselves in our rogues gallery. But now it's time to go to the first and see who William is torturing on the tee.
I'm here on the team with Hot Pants, and representing Hot Pants today is?
Richard Hadrill.
And Simon Lovell.
Okay, I noticed you got your arm around him.
I know, he's very, with a very close name? Friend of mine.
And who's the better player of you two?
No, he is by far.
You can't make your mind up?
No, he definitely him.
What are we playing off today?
Nine today.
Nine?
I'm 18.
18, so you're the one with the shots and you're the one with the talent.
We hope it's that way.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Churchfield Old Boys.
How did that go for your first tee?
A bit nerve-wracking, wasn't it? But managed to get it away, which is the main thing.
And do you get out and play much golf?
Yeah, about four times a day, generally.
Where's your home club?
Ogbourne Downs.
Okay.
Between Swindon and Marlborough.
And how are you thinking this course is looking today?
Well, the boys have played it before, but it looks like you really set it up quite well. Looks in good nick, so we're looking forward to a good day.
Greens were good.
Have a great day.
Thank you very much.
With a couple of guys representing Awesome, the main sponsor of the day, and your names are?
Charles Hardwick.
And Toby Leighton Pope.
Now, how do you feel about representing Will Orr? I mean, he's a big man here today and he's sponsoring the whole day. He's going to want to see a winning team.
We're looking to definitely finish on the podium spot.
Are you?
Yeah, we're not messing about.
What sort of standard of what handicaps are we playing off today?
13.
And 16.
Okay, so you've got a few shots to waste. And do you think you're going to use them wisely?
Yes, very much so.
Okay, that's it. What is the tactic today?
Go low.
I'm with Toby.
Yeah? So when you hit go low, you mean hit it off the sole of the club and keeping it low?
No,
thinning it.
Thinning it all the way around, yeah?
Yeah.
And now it's time for our first trip to the traditional Trilby Tour Rogues Gallery, where we feature some of the very worst golf played on the day and name and shame the perpetrators. This, for instance, is Nick Ginty of TK Hackers, who only managed to reach the women's tee with his very first shot of the day. And he didn't get much further with his second. Here, John Dean of Salisbury Slicers B shows he's a master of bunker play by hitting the ball just out of the sand and then watching it roll slowly back in. The 18th green at Hanbury is surrounded by some tricky bunkers, but here's Richard Burns of Perry Ellis B showing the way to deal with them is to blast your ball as hard and fast as you can. Back with John Dean displaying how, well, let's not bother with what he's displaying, at least he's enjoying himself. This is David Fisher of BC London A, inching ever closer toward the green. Inching. And here's his teammate Bruce Clark showing how to traverse the fairway with aplomb. Sorry, that should be traverse the fairway like a plum. Steve Watson of TK Hacks B obviously doesn't like his greens. And while our cameraman just missed his first attempt to get out of the bunker, he did get his second. Not to mention Steve's ignominious pickup. Never mind, Steve, no greens, but you got your just desserts. Let's get back to William on the first.
Hi, I'm here with Andy Dance, the main perpetrator of putting this whole day together. Andy, how's it going so far?
Well, the day's going very well, but the golf's appalling.
How would you compare this to the Trilby Tour that you saw yesterday?
Well, I'm just pleased that we're good friends, because I can't believe that you would never put your names to these golfers.
I've actually been round with a big felt tip marking out my name on all the banners.
I don't blame you.
Andy,
you got it all for charity.
Have you got any early tips for winners?
The early tips? I think we're going to be here all night, to be honest with you.
I think what you're saying is it's hard to pick a winner because they're all so rubbish.
They are indeed. Yeah?
Swingers, FC UK, what are you hoping for out of today?
Just a real good game, really. Hope to bring the best out of each other and just to have an enjoyable round.
Now, I've been told your golf's shocking, is that true?
It depends who you heard it from.
Pretty much everyone I asked.
It's probably true then.
And what about you, what are you hoping for?
I'm just hoping to beat Graham today. So we have a battle every week and today's my day.
Who normally wins?
Me. So I'm going for it again. But we've got a little bit on it, haven't we?
Yeah.
And you seem to be playing on your own. That seems to be a bit of a handicap for the scoring. How's that going to work?
Nobody likes me, obviously. So I've lost all my mates. I just want to beat my partner.
Well, good luck to you, chaps. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Thanks very much.
Time to head back to Rogues Gallery and Paul Kelly of TK Hacks B, deciding whether to go over the tree, to go under the tree, or to just scuttle it along the buggy path, before Paul settles for just a few feet forward of where he was, K Keep going, Paul. You'll get there. Steve Lewington of Hardy Amos B sees no point in bothering the fairway. Now here's an inspiring sequence of play from Naheed Batty of Pentland B. First, he favours the rough by the green. Then he escapes the rough by the green for some more rough just a few feet in front of him. And we might as well stay with him, for this could be an accomplished and inspiring chip straight into the cup, or a hopeless dink into another bit of rough. Who'd have guessed? Now, concentrate, Naheed. You have to make this one count. And yes, he's on the green in about seven. So his partner decides to do the right thing and avoid further embarrassment. And here is his partner, George Davidson, demonstrating not only his bunker skills, but also his overshooting skills. In a fetching sock and short combo, Steve Spelling of Awesome Queens B is playing straight and true and right into a bunker. Adam Ahrens of Brand Alliance B is also something of a bunker meister, but he prefers the long, slow crawl along the rough before entering the sand. Now, it's back to William for some more first tee chat.
I'm here on the first tee with the Royal Ridge Rollers. You are?
I'm Gavin.
Okay, Gavin.
Rawlings.
Okay, nice to let us know. And you are?
I'm Scott Pickering.
Scott Pickering. Tight team?
Absolutely.
Yeah,
doesn't it look like it?
This team is honed with years and years of profession.
We've travelled the world.
Travelled the world playing golf, okay. Yeah. And where exactly have you travelled to?
Australia.
Okay.
Marbella.
Yeah, okay. And you obviously don't read emails? No? Yes? No?
Simple. No, obviously not, no.
Because there's an email saying out matching tops.
Well, yeah.
Gavin, you've got no stock, I take it.
I wasn't coming in. No? He was supplying today.
Oh, did he have one to fit? Was that what it was?
Yeah, that was
okay, what
it was.
Yeah. I'm here with TK Maxx lawyers. Mm.
Yeah.
They're an interesting bunch of guys. They've been giggling and cracking jokes all day long, but being very careful what they say about people. So in the interest of being very careful with the TK Maxx lawyers, guys, are you having fun?
Absolutely. Very much so. 3 a.m. finish last night.
Oh my God, was that practicing?
Peak physical condition.
Was that talking tactics?
No, that was a thought of TK Maxx.
No, oh, what happened there?
A couple of shandies.
Yep.
Several bottles of red wine.
Here on site?
On site.
Yeah. So a venue.
Warming up.
Obviously, inspected the venue.
Yeah. Every corridor and every bar.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. What exactly are you looking for?
More.
Off in front of a fair crowd here.
Yes.
You've got the Sky Sports cameras and you've knobbed two straight to the right. How does that feel?
It felt pretty strange. They went straight. I wasn't facing the right way.
All the right shots, just not in the right order.
Absolutely
okay,
right.
Okay, so what are you going to do? How are you going to recover on this hole?
I think I'm going to go and get my lawnmower
yeah.
and my scythe and I'll have a quick look.
Okay, I've got better ideas. Just go straight the second tee.
I think you're absolutely okay. right.
Play well, have a good play day. Well the rest
thanks,
of the game.
Thanks ever so much.
Time for a final trip to Rogues Gallery, and here's our friend Adam Ahrens again, showing what a fairway scuffer he is. At least I think that's what he says. Lance Davis of Awesome Orson clearly loves bunkers, so determined is he to stay in them. And here's Bruce Clark again with an approach to the fairway which he hits well enough, but where it goes, no one knows. Not him, not our cameraman, not no one. Fairway to heaven's be Sam Hardman proves a hard man to beat when it comes to scuffing a shot way off target. Way, way off target. And now a Waterworks specialist first, Stephen Crawford of Brand Alliance A, gives a high ball a thorough soaking. And then his teammate, Kirk Hannaford, follows his lead at the same hole, this time with a little skibberoo. And before we finish, let's go back to the first to our old pal Bruce Clark and this woeful effort. Finally, we can all delight as, yes, it's that man again, Stephen Crawford, tops his tee shot. Luckily, William is on hand as first tee ball spotter and very kindly points out just exactly how far Stephen managed to get. He's a good man, that Mr. Hunt. So let's go back to the first and join him for the final time.
I'm here on the tee with Team Awesome, Awesome B. Obviously saving the best to last, boys.
Yeah, well, we're ready. We've sent the ringers out first and we've got the muscle at the end.
Good lads. And your handicap today? Give us a name. And
My name's Lawrence Davis, 18 handicap.
Okay, so you got a few shots. Now, Will's a good player. Will Orr, we'll say Will, before we go any further, big thank you for today, for being the major sponsor of today's event. So I think we should take our Trilbies off to you for that.
William, I'm just following your lead, sir.
But no, I think it's a great big thanks we owe you today.
Thank you. My pleasure.
But it would be fitting today, with the efforts you put into this, for you to win, I think.
There's no guarantees, William.
I've seen you play, I've played with you, and you're a good player, Will.
Thank you. And I can have my moments.
You can?
And I'm hoping to have some moments.
Okay, I'm going to ask you another question. What do you think might go wrong today?
7-iron.
Okay.
7-iron from 150, it didn't work.
No? Try an easy six?
I don't know. I'll let you know at the end.
I have a strong feeling today, Will, you're going to feature on that scoreboard.
Me too.
If not, you'll be abused.
Good partners, no problem.
We'll be right back.
think I love you.
At the end of the day, there was a one-hole playoff between the top four pairs to see who would become the TK Maxx Comic Relief Golf Day Champions. Facing off to go down the 18th were Sock Shop Shockers A, West Coast A, Juice Court A, and Sir Fanic Swingers B. Sadly, to be frank, the light was so dim and the golf was of such a poor standard, we have decided not to inflict the full horror of what occurred on an unsuspecting audience. We had to live through it, but there's no reason anyone else should suffer. Suffice to say that the eventual winners were Jack Strawman and John Mears of West Coast A. At least we think they were. To be honest, it was so dark out there, any of the teams could have been the winners. The main thing is, a great day was had by everyone involved. Thanks to all the players, the ground staff, the stewards, and of course, the sponsors. We'll see you all again next year.